Indiana, we're all wanting more money for education. The way you get more money for schools is to increase the population of schools. And the way to do that is more kids. More kids means you need more people to move into your area. And my concern is if we build these facilities in populated areas of the state, there'll be no new growth. The technology changes. What we're building as far as wind turbines right now, some of those are already obsolete. My concern is if we cut the subsidy, they became obsolete, then what happens to the ones that are left there? The proposals to fund the decommission, I really think there's some holes in that. I don't think there's any protection that that money would be there to take those down if they decommission them. And I jokingly say that you can't get a couple of guys in a good old boys in a pickup truck and a cutting torch, they can't take those down. So my concern is they're going to the landscape pollution of our communities for the future is something I think we should be concerned about. This issue has torn my community apart. We got fathers and sons disagreeing on whether they should or they shouldn't. He happened to be a county surveyor for Illinois, and he surveyed the locations for the turbines, and they were putting three turbines around his house. He didn't care, but after the turbines were constructed and turned on, then he and his family began having problems with their sleep pattern. And doesn't affect everybody, does affect some. You have the problem and the concerns about the flicker factor, you have the concerns about property values. Henry County was getting growth from Indianapolis in the Knightstown area and from Anderson up around Middletown. But when they came to buy houses in our communities and they found out that there was a lease to put a wind farm a half a mile or a mile down the street, they backed out of those sales. So I think that's firsthand proof that it does affect the quality of life and where people want to live. Property rights issue is a big deal. The farmers, it's our property right, you know. It is, but once you start affecting your neighbor's property rights, and there has to be a fairness issue here. I live in a big agriculture community, but I have a lot of CAFOs in my area. But if you can't keep that odor on your property, you are affecting my property rights, you are affecting my property quality of life. Same way with the wind turbines. They want to call or write their legislators, that's the best thing they can do.